Now let us see the concept of simple band break. I'll draw the diagram for this. Now here is the diagram of a simple band break. In this, first I will consider the rotation of the break drum in clockwise direction. Now when we talk about band break, it consists of a band which is wrapped around the drum over which we want to have the breaking action. It means this bend would be stopping this drum, and the arrangement is such that at point O we are having the fulcrum, that is the fixed end, and one end of the band is attached at the fulcrum. The other end of the band is attached at a distance of X from the fulcrum. L is the distance from point O, which is the fulcrum, to the point where effort is applied, or in other words we can say that L is the length of this lever. Now when I am considering the clockwise rotation, what happens is that because of the clockwise rotation of the drum, the bend is pulled from, I will say that this is point B, the bend is pulled from point B and then it is delivered towards O. So from the clockwise rotation we can easily understand that the band is pushed, or it is pulled from B and it is pushed towards the fulcrum. Now where it is being pulled, that becomes tension in tight side. Where it is pushed, that becomes tension in slack side. Now this is the diagram which we have, in which we are getting the belt tensions here, and whenever we have the band break, in that case we need to consider the tension in the belt. Now for clockwise rotation, I'll say that for clockwise rotation, in order to make the breaking action, what will happen, that here we have the lever and the bend is attached to this brake drum. When we are applying the effort in the upward direction, that is when here we have the lever, and when the lever is pushed in the upward direction, then the belt here which we are having at point B, as the effort moves up along with it, this point B, this would also be moving up, and thereby we would be having the belt tension which stops this brake drum. So this is the functioning of a simple band break. Here I'll say that taking moments, that is summation of moments about all forces at point O is equal to zero for the equilibrium condition. Here clockwise moment will be positive and anti-clockwise moment negative. Therefore here I have minus P into L. Next, the moment of tension T2, that is tension in slack side, it will be zero because it is passing through point O, but T1 is producing clockwise moment, so it is plus T1 into X is equal to zero. Therefore if I shift T1 into X, it goes into the other side, becomes minus T1X, minus minus cancel, so P will be equal to T1 into X divided by L. So from this equation I can say that I can calculate the value of the amount of effort which is required at the end of the lever in order to stop this drum which is rotating. Now this was an example for clockwise rotation. Now similarly here I'll draw the diagram for anti-clockwise rotation. Now in the second case, here I am considering rotation of brake drum in anti-clock direction. As the brake drum rotates in anti-clockwise direction, it would be pulling the band, or we can say belt, from point O, that would be tension in tight side, and delivering it to point B, so that is tension in slack side. So here the directions of belt tension, they have changed. For clockwise rotation, the belt was pulled from point B and delivered at O. For anti-clockwise rotation, the belt is pulled from point O and delivered at point B. Now here I'll again say that since for anti-clockwise rotation, summation of moment about point O is equal to zero, clockwise moment positive and anti-clockwise moment negative. Therefore, so here we can see that minus P into L, because it is anti-clockwise, minus T2 into X, again it is anti-clockwise, and that is equal to zero. So therefore P is equal to minus T2 into X, because when this T2 into X shifts onto the other side, this would be positive and here we have negative sign. So it becomes minus T2X divided by L. So again from this we are getting the value of effort for simple band break. So here we have seen two cases, that is for clockwise rotation and for anti-clockwise rotation for a simple band break. Based on this we would be solving some problems. Now after simple band break, I'll go on to differential band break and we would be solving the problems together, that is for simple as well as differential band break. So once we have understood the concept of simple band break, now we would be going on to differential band break. Again for differential band break, I'll draw the diagram. In case of differential band break, there is difference in the construction of the lever, as we can see from the simple band break. Now here we can see there is a big brake drum and to it there is a band attached. Here is the lever. Next I'll say that this is the fulcrum denoted as O. Now the distance of one end of the band which is attached to the lever from the fulcrum, I'll say that the distance is A. Next, where the other end is attached, this distance I'll call it as B. Next, where the effort is applied, this will be called as the length of the lever. Now, when I'm considering the clockwise rotation, I'll say that taking moments of all forces about point O. Now when I'm considering the clockwise rotation, we can see that I'll say that this is end A, this is the end B, the bend is pulled from end B, so here we are having tension which is called as tension in tight side because it is being pulled. Next, after that, this band is delivered to point A. This I'll call it as T2, tension in slack side. So here I have three forces, effort which is applied, tension in tight side, tension in slack side. So when I'm taking the moment, summation of moment about point O is equal to zero, clockwise moment positive and anti-clockwise moment negative. Therefore, here I have P into L because it is clockwise. Next, T1 into B. Next, it is T2, which is coming into clockwise direction. So it is plus T2 into A, plus T2 into A is equal to 0. Therefore, I would be getting P is equal to T1 into B. When it goes on to the other side, that would be negative. And here also I have. So this will be minus T1 into B, minus T2 into A, divided by L. So from this equation, I would be getting how much is the effort which we are applying at the end of the lever in case of differential band break so as to stop this brake drum. And therefore braking torque will be, it will be tension in tight side minus tension in slack side multiplied by the radius of the brake drum, which is R. So in this way we would be calculating the braking torque. So this was regarding the differential band brake. Now with the concept understood, we can easily start with the problems on simple and differential band brakes.